Judas. Judas was one of the 12 disciples of Jesus. Judas was a man chosen to be one of the leaders of the apostolic college and also one of the leaders in the early church. That's why Jesus selected him amongst others to be an apostle. So he was selected to be a confidant, a trusted friend of Jesus. In fact, an insider of the ministry of Jesus, the household of Jesus. But he allowed himself to be used by the devil. And that's why a lot of people do not pity Judas, because he's been accused of being culpable, a misuse of the freedom he had as a person who ordinarily was supposed to be a responsible child of God, but he allowed himself to be used. There are so many technicalities in that text of scripture. First of all, it says in verse 3, the devil did what? Entered who? Judas. Meaning, he was possessed. The devil took over. In fact, the devil entered Judas two times. The first time was this particular moment that the devil entered him. And when the devil entered him, he began to walk on him. And when he entered him, he says, then he began to urge him to go ahead and betray Jesus. Now, betraying Jesus was not just at any other time. Not at any other time, but at a holy season. Passover feast. You remember the Passover. That is going back to the time of old. Going back to Exodus chapter 12. When the Lord said, this day Israel will depart. This day Pharaoh will let my people go. This day Israel will depart Egypt under the pain of death of every firstborn child in Israel. When God accomplished his promise and his faithfulness to the people of Israel. When the angel of death passed over the house of Israel in Egypt and killed every firstborn child in the land of Egypt. That is what we are going back to. That was the season when God eventually told them, when you leave Egypt and settle in the land that I am giving you, this day must be the first day. You must always celebrate this moment. And so it is a holy season when people gather in Jerusalem to celebrate this momentous time in history and in the life of the children of Israel, that these men plotted the death of Jesus. Judas allowed himself. Again, you will recall that that particular experience or that particular scene is also quite a fulfillment of the prophecy of Zechariah in chapter 11, from verse 12 to 13, where they talk about the amount of money that was going to be paid, 30 pieces of silver, and that money would be a body of blood that would throw into the field of blood. There, in Zechariah chapter 11, it's talked about what was going to happen to Jesus. But then, it is destined that Jesus will die, but Judas allowed himself to be a person. Watch this. When you are in the seat of power, when you are even in the house of God, when the devil comes knocking, or when Satan comes knocking, your position in the house of God could be a gateway to hell. Praise the Lord. That I'm a priest is a gateway, can be a gateway to hell. That you are always in the church can also offer an opportunity for the devil to tempt you and lead you into hell. And that was exactly what happened to Judas. And so it's a warning for us. You might occupy a particular position in church, a privileged position in that manner, but it opens the door for you to be tempted and Jesus also in the same Matthew's gospel, in Luke's gospel chapter 22, had to pray for his disciples when he said to Peter in verse 21, look, the devil has been given authority, has been given power to tempt all of you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Everybody say all of you.
All of you.
All of us.
All of us.
The devil has been given power to tempt all of you so that you might fall away. Praise the Lord. But the Lord comforts somebody, and that is Peter. He said to Peter, I have prayed for you so that when you arise, you will lift up your brothers. I pray for that grace of covering from God for us this morning in the name of Jesus. The devil may have been given opportunity to tempt all of us, but there is a window of grace given to us, and that window of grace is for protection. My dear friends, men may have not slept through the night because of you.
Hey.
Judas and the elders plotted the outfall of Jesus. They did not sleep. You see, some of us here today, and some of you will be going to your shop this month, right? I've had a couple of people who come and tell me, Father, when I got to my shop this morning, I saw sheep in front of my shop. I saw blood spilled in front of my shop. Have you ever had that experience before? When you are busy over the weekend, attending to weekend activities and also going to church, some persons are busy going to places because of you. Let us see how you will come this Monday morning and open the shop. Let us see whether by the time he steps in there, whether he will not pass through and fall. Let us see whether this month will pass him by. I don't care who has made a night journey for you. Your morning journey shall determine to whatever night journey they have made against you in the name of Jesus. Anybody who, like Judas, kept sleepless nights because of you in order to destroy you, that person shall be disgraced in the name of Jesus. Again, Judas and his cohorts, they plotted the downfall of Jesus. But they were afraid of the people. If you go to chapter 21 of Luke's Gospel, about verse 28 or thereabouts, it says, the people believed in Jesus as a prophet. And after each day, Jesus will return to the Mount of Olives. And then he says, early in the morning, the people will come back to the temple to listen to him because they believe that he is a prophet. They believe in his teaching. Because many of them have also confessed, we have never seen a teaching like this. There is so much power attached to his teaching. Not like our teachers. His teaching is a teaching with a difference. And that brought about the popularity of Jesus among the people. So they believed in him. And there is no way you can try such a man in public and the people will not revolt. Amen.
Amen.
If I tell you this morning, that Bishop called me yesterday and said I will leave tomorrow, or by the end of this month, what will you do? He said what? But I came so that I would go someday. Did I come to stay forever? If the person who sent me says that I came, please, by the end of this month, you will have to go to somewhere else. Amen. I'm only trying to paint a scenario.
scenario for you.
The reaction of the people sometimes.
And so that was the situation with Jesus.
And the scribes and the Pharisees, they knew this. They knew that they could not just watch Jesus because he was special.
Child of God, I want to tell you this morning that you are special.
I want to tell you this morning that you are the apple of God's eye. I want to tell you this morning that God is carrying you on an eagle's wings. You are a precious child in the eyes of God. And anybody that is thinking evil of you, too shall be that person's reward. Because you are a special child of God. When men rose against the Israelites, when the Egyptians fought against the Israelites, they wanted to suppress them and oppress them and oppress them to nobody. There was a God who was overlooking over them. They did not know that their God was a big, big God. Hey, your God is too big. You are God. Said you can only keep a message, but you cannot keep a word. got the message.
When he misbehaves in the family, I drive my car to the village and I
of Jesus.
Guy.
That's what the name says. Resist him!
evil will flee from you, because your Father is Elohim. Because the Lion of the tribe of Judah is your God. Because the Prince of Peace is your God. Because he who holds the keys of life and death is your Master. That is why you have to walk confidently. When you are moving about, move confidently. Because you belong to a race that is greater. They can pounce and plot, but they will never get you. The word of silence, you say that you will no longer speak, you will speak. And when you speak, men will stand in your honor. They will stand and listen to you. In the name of Jesus. In Acts chapter 4, Peter and John went on mission. In fact, before then, in Acts chapter 3, they went to the temple, and as they approached the temple, they met a beggar. Because they have been empowered in Acts chapter 2 to speak by the Holy Spirit, they began to do that work. When men want to suppress and oppress you, and God says no, when the time comes, when the fullness of time comes, you will explode. And when you explode, it will be explosive. When the disciples exploded from the upper room, it became what? Explosive and devastating. And nobody could stand. Everybody was hiding their face. And then they continued in Acts chapter 3. Peter went there, and the beautiful gate, he healed the crippled man. And they gathered, everybody gathered, what is this new thing that is happening in power? They said, nothing new. It's about Jesus. It's about you. You love Jesus. You love him. Are you sure? You love Jesus. So what I'm telling you this morning is about Jesus. Tell your neighbor, it's about Jesus. It's not about him. You get me? You are not here this morning because of Father, but it's about who? Jesus. And crippled man come up and walk. Some of your businesses are crumbling. They will get up. I said they will get up. There will be revival. There will be revival. There will be great crippledness into your business. Your business shall start again. You will stand again. If wickedness let them destroy all the places, you will survive. No problem. God will save you and God will lift you up. Even in the midst of all those things, God is providing opportunity for some of you to become shop owners and landlords, even in the midst of all that.
Time is a goal, Jesus, time is a goal,
this government will go down.
Don't be sorry.
Don't allow any human being push you to be me and you will suffer soon. Amen. That's not the end of your life. On Friday, I told those who came here that your past is not the last destination of your life. 2020, year of coronavirus, was not the last bus stop of the world. The world is moving. How many persons are putting masks? Huh? Talk to your neighbor. How many persons? There was a time we were not gathering. Don't be so. We have come back. Is he your baby? Who? Because you'll be soon be a young priest, now I'm a good priest now. Praise the Lord.
When I visit some of our young priests, I tell them, see, you see Paraben, and then you see, most of them see me now, they look at me walking. I say, bro, please. You see this man? I have seen the good, the bad, and the ugly in the priesthood. Any side of the priesthood you bring, Paraben has seen it. And there are about three of us in this day, so I've seen the bad, the good, and the ugly of the priesthood. And I can beat my chest and tell you, whatever I'm over there, I am here now. If Bishop like Paraben and this, I said, my Lord, no problem, I'm available. When you have seen it all, nothing scares you anymore. And that was the experience of the disciples of Jesus. When we go to a point, they called them, and then they gave them an please, don't, this time I will add please to you. They will not give you a command. When they cannot look at your face and give you a command, they will only say, please. They said to them, please. You no longer talk about this thing, but you will look at it. Because your testimony will be giving one. Amen. They begged them not to talk about him. And they said they dismissed them. Other times, the disciples did not stop. In fact, I think they flogged them. And Peter rejoined. They rejoined that they were flogged because of the name of Jesus. These are not killing. Those who protest against you will be those who will give you, show you the way. You can go through this way, but tread softly. You were sleeping, though. You went to the weekend, and they were planning for you. You will come back, you will go to the shop this morning. You will go to your office this morning. And favor will follow you. Don't say what will guide us. And you will be joyful. The devil will not play. Daniel, in the book of Daniel and his friends, in chapter 3, because of their good work, people plotted against them. So, child of God, when they are plotting against you, do not be scared. It began with your master. He says, if they have done this when the wood is green, what would they do when it is what? Dry. That's what Jesus says. If they did it to your master, how much more you? If men plotted to kill Jesus for doing a good job, because he asked them, for which of these are you slapping me? For speaking the truth, for healing the people. That you slap me. Say, why do you slap me? He had testimony of good. Yet they plotted his downfall. So, child of God, brace for action. You should be strong in faith. Stop living in fear. Judas, an insider of Jesus' ministry, betrayed him. Not an external person. There are many of you, those who want to destroy you from inside. Sometimes your boy you have kept in the shop is a person they used to plot against you. Don't be so. You tell him to go to a packing store to go and bring goods. 5. He will bring out 10 and hide the other one somewhere. Eh? Did you do like that? You send him something he sells, and he's saving money in somebody's account. Before you know it, he has opened the shop, and one quarrel between you and him, he leaves and begins a business and stops good. For most times, such things don't progress. Don't cheat your master in order to make good money. Be a sincere and honest word, servant, and then God will bless you. That's my prayer for you this morning. In the name of Jesus. My dear friends, every plot that is against you, especially a plot that is coming as a result of your honest disposition, like Daniel in Daniel chapter 6, they plotted against him because of the way he administered the empire.
rose up against him and they could not find faults. Everybody say, find faults. They could not find fault with him. They said, the only way we will find fault with him is his religion.
Amen. I know there's somebody here in your life, they don't like you because you're a churchman or churchwoman. Don't be so.
Even in the yard, they don't like you because you're a churchman. When they see you with the rosary on your neck, every time you're singing, Ezine Maria, you, Mama, oh, Maria, they saw. Eh? What can I sing about that? Ezine Maria, you, Mama, oh, Maria, they saw.
Ezine Maria, you, Mama, oh, Maria,
they saw. And they will see you in that day.
They will be subdued because of the joy of God in you.
They prophet to Israel because of his religion. And they went ahead and plotted.
And they set trap. The trap caught him, but he was freed. So shall you be freed.
Your religion will pave way for you. Your belief in God will pave way for you. Your God will speak for you. God will prove to you that he is your shepherd. Because he says in Psalm 23, the Lord is my watch, and I shall not want. He makes me lie down. I want everybody to recite that Psalm. He makes me lie down in what? Green pastures. Do you believe that? If you believe it, can I see you stand? He makes me lie down in what? Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, no evil would I want. I need three persons into this order. Three.
And no, it's not enough, I don't complete.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, no evil would I want.
Say that.
No evil would I want. Because you are there with your crook and your word, stand to do what? To defend me.
Amen.
He will set a table for me. He will set a table for you. In the sight of your foes. He will set a table for you. He will set a table for him. He will set a table for you.
Jesus.
The God who sets table for his children will set a table for you. In that office they say you will not grow, you shall grow. In that place of business they say you will fail, you will not fail in the name of Jesus. You will not fail in the name of Jesus. This will be your season of favor in the name of Jesus. The Lord who thwarted the plot of Judas and the chief priest will thwart the plot of the enemy against you in the name of Jesus. Favor will follow you. Your cup will run over. Your cup of favor will run over. Your cup of favor will run over. Every satanic ingredient in you will bow to the glory of God in your life in the
Jesus. In your family, there will be no satanic influence in the name of Jesus. Satan entered Judas twice. That Satan authority operating in your life will bow to the glory of God in your life this day in the name of Jesus. Every satanic manipulation in your life, I raise the fire of the Holy Ghost against it in the name of Jesus. Every satanic projection in your family, in your business, in your workplace, this day, that it will bow to the name of Jesus. The Lord will reposition you. The Lord will reposition you. The Lord says they will come from one direction, but they shall be scattered in seven directions. In the name of Jesus.